Good morning, guys. Welcome to Sports Conditioning. Take another minute to stretch anything that feels stiff or tight. If you got a foam roller, grab your foam roller. We'll need that today. We'll also need a pair of dumbbells, maybe a band if you got it, and a mat. I'm going to have to reclaim my mat here. A little Cora's licking her paws. All right, guys, grab a foam roller. We'll get it going here. We're going to foam roller your upper back first. Got your foam roller, place this against the grain or sideways. If you don't have a foam roller, you could also just stretch. You could stretch out your upper body, stretch your back. Okay. All right. We'll take a minute to roll out your upper back. Should feel pretty good. If you got a smart watch, you can set that. Make sure you're going to get credit for your calories burned for there. We're going to start out easy. We'll get a good 10-minute warm-up, and then we'll get into the circuit. We've got four different circuits today of four exercises. And then after you had enough foam rolling your upper back, you could roll out your lats underneath your shoulder. Then once you find a knot, you could just move your arm overhead and then back down. So the idea here is that you're on a knot and you're sandwiching the knot in between your shoulder blades and the foam roller. And again, if you don't have a foam roller, you could also just stretch your mat by reaching sideways. All we're doing is just trying to relax the muscle tissue. Oh, I got to stop tearing my screen there. Sorry about that. Get my disclaimer down. My fault. And then you can switch sides. All together is a leather lat. Your lats actually run from your biceps and your shoulder all the way down onto your lower back. So again, find that knot and then move your arm up and down. Or if you don't have that foam roller, you could just do a lateral stretch. That's the shoulder and the lats. After you've had enough of the foam rolling your lats, you can try rolling out your upper back again, but this time go arms overhead. And you got the idea by now, if you don't have a foam roller, you can just reach overhead, do some back bends to stretch the whole front side of your body. After you've had enough rolling out your upper back, you can flip it over onto your elbows, and we're going to roll your quads from just above your knees down to just above your hips. If you're just showing up, we're rolling out your quads, trying to find any tight tissue above the knee, below the hip. And then once you find that knot, you could turn your feet in and out so you kind of roll that femur. And again, just kind of relax the muscle tissue on the front side of your thigh. Once you had enough in that spot, you can move a little bit higher. We just have one more with the foam roller. Again, if you don't have a foam roller, you could just stretch out your quads by grabbing a foot behind your back, or you could do it lying down, grabbing a foot. And then once those muscles relax a little bit, you can make your way over onto your backside, and we'll roll out your calves. You could go two at the same time, or you could cross one leg over the other to get more pressure onto the ankle and the calf muscles. starting at the Achilles tendon all the way down behind the ankle joint, or the medial or lateral malleolus, those bumps in the side of your ankle. It's your fibula bone and your tibia bone coming to an end. There's a lot of attachments there. And after you had enough on that leg, you could switch legs and roll out the other calf. This should feel maybe a little tender, maybe a little painful. If it's too painful, just go feet apart and you can pull them all this way. All right. Once you had enough of the foam roller, make your way onto one knee. I want to do an ankle mobility exercise. So starting in half kneeling, keeping the heel on the ground, try to drive your knee as far forward as possible. Hold that stretch for a few seconds and then repeat for 5 reps. So we got a few minutes of stretching and then we'll start the circuit. After 5 reps, you're just doing like a 3 to 5 second hold. You can switch legs. The goal here is to keep that heel on the ground. Exhale, you stretch. After 5, we're going to do a hip flexor stretch. So same exact position, but walk that foot forward a little bit further. Drive your hips forward. Feel a stretch here. Hold that for a few seconds and then straighten out the front leg into a hamstring. Hold this for a few seconds and then pop back up into that hip flexor. And alternate between the two, hamstring stretch, hip flexor stretch. You feel good, a good stretch for the hip flexor here, and then when you go forward, hamstring stretch. We'll do 5 of each. This is my last one. After 5, you can switch legs. Switch it up. A little bit more stretching than usual. Same movements, guys. Hip flexor stretch, hamstring stretch. Hold for 3 to 5 seconds. Alternate the two exercises. And of course, if you can get your feet further apart than I can, that would be good. Try to get more of a stretch. Some people might be able to get their hips all the way down to the ground. I'm not even close. Do your best. Wherever you are, that's fine. My 4th one. Last one, hip flexor. And then a hamstring. All right, go ahead and lift that back leg off the ground. Runner's lunge, rotate your hands to the side, press your knee out. Repeat. You might feel your body temperature going up even though we're just stretching and foam rolling. That's the idea. We're just doing more of a mobility warm up today. No jumping. We'll get a little bit of jumping in the workout today. We'll do 5 reps, going from straight ahead to the side and then pressing your knee out. Trying to open the hips up, especially the adductor here, the inner thigh. After 5, you could switch legs. Start straight, walk your hands to the side, press that knee out. inhaling when you're here, exhaling when you're stretching. Now, if it feels good just to hold it, you could also just hold these stretches, that's fine. But moving back and forth may allow you to get deeper into the stretch. And if it's really, like, tender, you're not going to irritate the nerve just holding it for a short stretch. All right, guys, last one. Hold the deep squat. Try to get your heels to the ground. Press your knees out. And then drop a hand to the ground. Reach up in the air. Alternate sides. Try to mobilize your ankles and the T-spine here. Last stretch. Kind of like a catcher's position in baseball. How about those Padres, huh? Second place behind the Dodgers. Roll out your wrist. They're doing pretty good. Ticket prices have gone up. Rightfully so. A few neck rolls. And then if you need to, grab a sip of water and grab some bands. I've got a yellow band. Looks like this. I'm gonna be using this for a shoulder raise. So it should be pretty light. I'll show you one of the exercises in the circuit. It's gonna look like this. Front raise. You also have like a super band, I'll tell you that. Bye, Jenna. Have a good day. Love you. All right. And then you're going to step. So if you got a super band, it'll look like this. Sorry. Just different types of bands. Any of those will work. I'm going to use this one today. We got a plank rotation first. Lateral lunge, front raise, and then skater. So four exercises. We're gonna go for 30 seconds each. And we'll get 20 seconds to transition between each. And 30, oh, there we go, 30 seconds. Okay, there we go. So it'll be about a 10-minute circuit. We've got four circuits. All right, we'll go in 10 seconds. First one looks like this, starting your elbows. One hand up in the air, alternate other hand up in the air. When this timer turns red, we're working. Here we go, just turn red. I'm gonna turn the volume up on that so you could hear it, hopefully. Sometimes my earbuds cut out the sound though. So I'll let you know when the timer starts to stop. At least you know when it's red, you're working. When it's blue, you're resting. Time, nice job. All right, your next one's that lateral lunge. So start out here, step out to the side. Here we go, alternate legs. I even missed the timer that time. There we go. Keep alternating legs, drop low into that side lunge. Hands out front. Kind of mobilize the hips again. Pretty athletic move here. Lateral lunge will be done in basketball, tennis, baseball. Done. Nice job. Grab that band. Raise his neck. Step on your band with one foot is going to be easier. With 2 feet is going to be harder. We'll go in 5 seconds. Go. All right, front raises with a band. If you don't have a band, you can also use dumbbells or water bottles. As you do the front raise, tall posture, chest up. I'm using a nice, very light band. You can see how thin it is. you got a dumbbell, you have a light dumbbell in each hand, maybe 3 pounds or 5 pounds. Nothing too heavy here. All right, the last one in the circuit is a skater. So you're just gonna hop from foot to foot and balance when you get to that foot. So we'll go slow at first. Looks like this. Find your balance and then jump back the other way. Okay. Skaters. Find your balance first and then jump. Here we go. Make sure your surface is clean and dry. Your mat is slippery, maybe you do it on the floor. Nice job, we're going to the mat. We're gonna do the plank with rotation next. Same four exercises, just two more rounds. So on this one, set your arms up across each other. Engage the core. Keep the hips and knees off the ground. Alternate directions. Go. Nice and tall, nice and long through the spine. Chest up. Hips up. Time to shot. Back to that lateral lunge. Good work. So starting with your feet together, kind of close to your body as you step out, arms shoot out in front of you. Your hands can kind of counterbalance your weight. And your hips can shoot backwards behind you. Five seconds, four, three, two. Nice job. Grab that band or your dumbbell, front raise. Next. Soft bend in the knees, chest up. Engage those core muscles. Squeeze your back, squeeze your abs. Go slow, stay under control with this one. Yeah, as you do this one, try to keep your arms straight as your hands go out front. Five seconds, four, three, two, time, nice job. So skater, hopping from foot to foot, this time go for height. Jump as high as you can off of one foot, land softly on the other. Working on balance here, acceleration, deceleration, and power. See if you can jump off of that one foot. Need to modify, you know, you're right. Right here, right? Stepping, finding that balance. Big arm movement. Time, nice job. All right, last round, same stuff. We'll go back to that plank with rotation. All right, hands crossed. Hips up, chest up. Might even be mobilizing your head and neck because you're looking up at your hand or you're looking down at your elbow. Your choice. Time, nice job. Lateral lunge. Feet together. Hands by your chest. Punch your hands out as you lunge. Hopefully this is a good level for you this morning. There's always ways to take up the intensity of the exercise. If you need to add weight, you can. If you want to increase the speed or tempo, you can. Grab your band, front raise. Elbow straight, chest up. Here we go. Might even be getting some of your mid-back here. Because as that band pulls you down or the dumbbells pull you down, you're trying to keep your chest up. Great, one for posture. Very functional. All right, skater. This time, jump as wide as you can. Big arm movement. Skaters. Land softly. Ready. Go. Wider, keep going. 3, 2. Nice job. Take a 2-minute break. Grab some water. Way to go. So we're gonna primarily work your upper body next. We got 4 more exercises. Curl and press. So if you got some dumbbells, great. We'll be doing that one standing. Or if you even got a medicine ball, you can do it with a medicine ball. Curl, press overhead. I'm gonna be using maybe some dumbbells on the first round, bicep curl, shoulder press. After that, we're gonna be lying down, doing a tricep extension. Lateral raise this time. So if you got those bands, we'll use the bands on the third exercise. Instead of going straight ahead, we'll go out to the side. Little dumbbells work well for that one too. It should be lighter on the resistance. And the last one's going to be a bear crawl. All right, guys, take another 30 seconds. Feel free to stretch if you need to. See a couple new names here. Glad you made it. See Barbara, Julie. Glad you guys are here. Going 10 seconds, guys. All right, first one's a curl and press. Bicep curl to a shoulder press. Keep the core tight. Here we go. Shoulders, arms. If it's too light, you can go heavier, or you can go faster. Try to keep the core tight and bring your hands all the way overhead till they finish right above your shoulders. Nice job. Your next one's on your back, lying down. Tricep extension. Start above your shoulders. Inhale. Exhale, push. Just watch out for your head. Wherever the dumbbells go is fine. It could be all the way overhead. It could be right next to your ears. It could be down by your chin. They're all variations of this exercise, and they're all good for you. If you have pain here, maybe you stretch your hands out a little bit overhead. Find an angle that works for you. Targeting your back of your arms here, your triceps. Let's jab up on your feet. Shoulder raises next. Paddle raise. Grab your light bands or your light dumbbells. You got a little dumbbell. Same movement. Looks like that. You got lighter bands. Step on your band with 1 or 2 feet is harder. Up to the sides this time. I like the band because you kind of get this pulling apart motion as you do the shoulder raise as well. So you get resistance from both directions. Nice job. Bear crawl is next. So if you have a mat, crawl the length of your mat forward and backwards, starting out in a bear position. Knees hover off the ground. Core is tight, chest is up. Here we go, 2 steps forward, 2 steps back. Nice job. Cool. 1 round done. 2 more rounds. Same stuff. Curl and press is next. I'm going to use a kettlebell this time, but find a weight that's good for you. Here we go. Nice job on your back. Triceps are next. Flying down, head on the ground, hips on the ground, feet on the ground. Shoot your hands overhead. Inhale, exhale as you push. Go. Nice job. Up on your feet. Grab your band or your little dumbbells. Lateral raise. Nice job getting here. Chris, T, Dennis, helping us. Katie, Martha, Teresa, Uni. Glad you guys are here. Time. Bear crawl is next. Take 10 seconds before we go. forward and backwards bear crawl. Two steps forward, two steps back. Here we go. Time, nice job. One more round, same stuff. Curl and press, tricep extension, lateral raise, bear crawl. Here we go. Curl, press. Last one. Nice job. On your back, tricep extension. Throw your hands above your shoulders. Inhale. Hold your breath. Exhale, you push. One more. Time. Shoulder raise. Out to the side. Low pace. Here we go. Better lead the movement with your elbows. So your hands don't come up first. So your elbows lead the movement. Means your deltoids are working. Upper trap, maybe a little bit of your lat. Five seconds. Nice job. Bear crawl is next. We're doing good on time. Here we go. Nice job. 2 minute break. Good job. Woo! 400 calories burned already. Doing good. All right, we got 2 more circuits. About 10 minutes per circuit. We got some core next, the bird dog. We got a side plank, hip dip. More core. So just your mat for those two. Pivot lunges where you step forward, step backwards, and then the shuffle side to side. Take another minute to catch your breath. Nice job. How are we doing out there? You guys doing good? Yeah? All right. Thanks, Teresa. Yeah, take another 45 seconds and we'll get it going. A bird dog is pretty easy, so a lot of core stability. Try not to twist as you do that one. Side plank could be tough. We got three rounds, so do the first two rounds all on one side. And then the last round, you could just switch halfway through. Okay. Another 20 seconds. All right, the bird dog for core. Oh. On your hands and knees. Fist. Alternate legs. Core stability here, so you don't have to race it. You can go slow. You can hold at the top for 2 seconds. This way you can kind of feel your muscles engage, your glutes, your lats, your abs. Cool. Onto your side. Side plank. We'll go all 30 seconds on this side. And you're just going to dip your hips up and down. So hand on your hip. You need to modify if you go hand on the ground, up and down. Or if you really need to modify, go bottom knee on the ground, up and down. Here we go. Take a breath when your hips go down. Exhale as you lift. Squeeze. You can do it forcefully. Last one. Nice job. All right, pivot lunges are next. You got a little dumbbell? You can grab a little dumbbell. Or big dumbbell. Or you can just go hands on your hips. Or you go hands behind your head.
Can I turn the other side? We're not doing the other side.
Next round. Okay. Thanks, Jimmy. Yep. Here we go. Pivot lunge forward and back. You know when we're halfway, and then we'll switch legs on this one. All right, switch legs. Time. Good. All right, side shuffle is next. We'll set up some little cones for fun. So athletic stance up in the balls of your feet. Touch the cone, shuffle. Touch the sneaker. Time. All right, bird dog. Shoulders right above your wrist, hips right above your knees, right arm, left leg. Pause and squeeze. Alternate sides. Nice job. We'll do that side plank on the other arm. The hip lift. Set up here. Or you're here. Your choice. Explosively lift. Inhale here. Exhale lift with force. Go. Nice job up on your feet. Pivot lunges. Woo! My legs are feeling a little heavy about now. Do your best. You could alternate legs on this one, or you could do 15 seconds. I'll let you know when we're halfway. One. Good side. Shuffle. Ready. Go. Forget about that forward bend and reach. Keep the core tight. Level changes are good for you. I'm good. One last round. Here we go. Shoulders over wrists. Hips over knees. Up and pause. Repeat. Other side. Five seconds. Side plank. We'll switch it 15 seconds. If you're ready, let's go for it. Exhale and lift. Inhale, come down. Job. If you're ready, you can switch sides. Go for about the same reps on each side. One more. Time. Nice job. Pivot lunges are next. Pretty good workout. Definitely sweating. For almost 500 calories, it's been 45 minutes. Doing good. Try switching this time, alternate legs. Takes a bit of coordination. Forward, backwards, switch. Last one. Time. Shuffle is next. Doing great, sports conditioning. Good. Over. Stay low. Low, stay low. Ball to your feet. Five seconds. Four, three. 2 minute break. Woo! Walk around, catch your breath. One more circuit. Ugh. Get the fan on in here. All right, so we got deadlift, 3-point sprint up, half kneeling chops, or slams. And then we'll do the bridge. Or the straight leg get up. Do the straight leg get up. We haven't really done much core, except for all the planks, right? Thinking those chops for a minute would be tough. You know, 30 seconds on one side, 30 seconds on the other. So we'll just split that up. So we'll go deadlift first. We'll start in 1 minute. If you don't have any dumbbells, you could also do a squat. All right. So we got, let's see. 9 minutes. We could be done right by 3 minutes, though. Should be good. We'll have a few minutes to stretch. All right, grab your dumbbells or your kettlebell. We'll do the deadlift first. Here we go. Chest up. Engagement through your back like you did on the third dog, all of the muscles working. Nice job. 3-point sprint next, or 3 points. One hand, 2 feet. Right here. Either bringing the knee up or forward. On one knee, or slam. I'll let you know when we're halfway. Half kneeling. Tap over the shoulder. On your back, straight leg, get up. Inhale here. Exhale, you sit up. Group. Back to your deadlift. Good job. You know that chick that used to dance a lot? Every night she'd be on the floor shaking what she'd got. Man, when chest up. Core tight. I mean she was steaming. And that time over at Johnny's place. Well, this chick got up and she slapped Johnny's face. Man, we just fell about the place. If that chick don't want to know, forget her.
Back in town. I said, boys are back.
All right, 3-point sprint up. Running low on fumes. Your choice, you're just doing that get up, sprint up. Feeling chop. Here we go. We never switch legs. Go ahead and switch legs. Get a few on the other side. My fault. On your back, straight leg get up. Oh, one more round, guys. Hang in there. Deadlift. 3-point sprint up, half kneeling chop. Here we go. Mother's Day coming up Sunday. Hopefully you got something nice for your mom or your wife or your sister. Flowers. 3-point sprint ups. Step. Acceleration. Half nailing shot. Here we go. Which legs? On your back. Last one, straight leg get up. Inhale, exhale, on your way up. Go. Coming to get you. time. Nice job. Line your back. Bring your knee to your chest. Circle the foot around a few times. And then when you're ready, straighten that leg up in the air. Get a good hamstring stretch. We've got some calf pumps here. Or a twist. Other leg, knee to chest. Circle the foot. Straighten the leg, grab the back of the thigh. Calf pump, point and flex the toe. Bend the knee, cross it across your body. Rock like a ball, bring both your knees to your chest, come all the way up onto your butt after a few rocking like a ball, and then a butterfly stretch. Leg out, reach up in the air, forward fold. Tuck your chin around your back, 600 calories burned, not bad. Switch legs, reach up in the air, exhale, forward fold. We'll go feet straight together. Just two more stretches and you guys can take off. Way up to standing. Grab a foot, stretch your quads. Excellent job today. I wasn't planning on making the workout be that tough, but felt like it was pretty hard. All right, feet together. Big inhale, circle your arms, reach up in the air. Exhale, forward fold. Fully rolled up. You made it through sports conditioning with Ryan. Great job today, guys. Thanks a lot for coming. Enjoy your Mother's Day on Sunday.
Thanks, Ryan. Have a great weekend.
Bye. Good job, you and you too. Thank you.
Thanks, Ryan.
Good job, Teresa. Weekend. Good job, Chris. You too. Enjoy it. Kopana, have a good day.
Thank you.
Good job. Martha, have a great day.